So we're going to start laying out by actually driving the ground post into the front left corner. And obviously the location of that's really important because everything else is going to be based on that, based on the house's size. So the first thing I want to do is put a mark on the ground post to know how deep it's going to go into the ground. Check the manufacturer's specs on this. Ground posts have to have a certain embedment and they have to have a certain depth in. This particular one, we're going to mark at 42 inches and we're going to bring that to the ground. We only want to measure one for the depth. And then after that, we're all going to level off the rest of our corner posts and the rest of our mid posts based on the depth of this one. When we drive these posts, so we use a ground post driver, and this should come with your kit from your manufacturer. This was sent by Rimmel Greenhouse Systems. And what this does is as we're smacking the top of this ground post, driving it into the ground, it's going to prevent it from mushrooming out. And it's going to allow us to hit directly with our hammer without deforming the top of that post. So let's find that front left post and we'll get started putting that in. This front left corner, if you're just out in the middle of an open field and you've already established your orientation of your greenhouse per the previous video, you'll know where that left one wants to be so that you can fit your house in the field. This house again being 30 foot wide by 96 feet long. This particular location, we're actually setting this up next to an established greenhouse. So we've measured off 12 feet from that greenhouse to allow space in between those houses for snow removal. And then from that, we've measured 30 feet over, which is the front width of the house. You can see we have holes drilled here. These holes are gonna bolt the top bow through. And so those holes need to be facing to the inside and outside of the greenhouse. This is the wrong configuration on those holes. So you wanna have them set up like this. And we're gonna run 96 feet in that direction and 30 feet in that direction. This is hard, slow work. And there are machines that can do this more easily, but be careful of your helper. And we're gonna work to level these up. So we can use a post level, or if we're using a traditional level, we want to make sure we're getting at least on two sides. And so as we're driving this, our helper is gonna periodically check to make sure that it's going in nice and straight and plumb. I'm getting old, or this ground is harder. Once we've got this started, we can send our helper away so that we can swing a little more forcefully. I'll make sure to stop periodically so that he can check the plumb. And if we need to adjust it at that point, we'll show you we can use a little strap to do that a little more safely. If we're out of level, we want our helper to be able to kind of put some tension on that post to be able to draw it back into level, but not be in the place where I'm going to potentially hit him or her in the head. So we can bring a strap in, have our helper apply some force that way as we drive.
A bit more to go, so.
And remember, we have our mark here, and this is the depth of this first post. So now when we measure, this house is going to be 96 feet in length. And these posts are 2 inches in diameter. So if we measured from the front edge of this post, we would need to make sure that back there we measured to the front edge. If we measured front edge to back edge, we gain two inches in that dimension. So John is going to hold it right about at the middle of this post. And I'm gonna run back 96 feet exactly, and we'll set the middle of that back post at that 96 foot mark. So let's go ahead and we'll set that. Right. And once we've got the left rear post in position, we'll drive it the same way. Yeah.
wasn't going anywhere.
No.
Yeah.
Up here in New Hampshire, we do have pretty rocky soil sometimes, and we really want to do what we can to get a proper embedment. Sometimes we can hit just the edge of a rock, and the pipe will actually deflect off it a little bit. Right now, we're getting a little bit of a tip in. I think that's what's happening, so I'm trying to pull it back out into level, and we'll see if we can continue to drive. A little trick, we can actually set a rock on the side that we're trying to move away from and use that to help pull us back. And that actually straightened that one up. So Dan's tying off to this hole at this point, and we're going to run that string and, using our line level, level between this hole and the hole in that pipe down there. Physics demands that that middle is going to sag, so we want to actually bring this line closer to the end. Your temptation is to hang it in the middle, but we actually want to not necessarily do that. Rimmel Greenhouse Systems supplies a little line level with their greenhouses, but of course you can buy this at a hardware store if you don't have one. If you want to take it a step up, using a laser level can really make the job a lot easier, but we're not going to cover that in this video. Yeah, we can go a little more. Good. So now we're going to set the front right post. And we're actually going to do that based on the diagonal measurement across the diagonal of this greenhouse, as well as by pulling a measurement off the very first post that we drove. So I'm going to run this tape now along the diagonal so that we can locate where that is. The greenhouse manufacturers, including Rimmel, will include what this diagonal dimension should be for all their different sized greenhouses, because every different greenhouse is going to have a different measurement. So if I tell you the measurement on this one, it might not be the one for your house. Remember what we learned before about on center? So Dan's going to hold this one on center, and we'll measure to the center of the post over there. Be fine if he did to the outside, I would just have to remember to do it to the inside. Wherever point he's measuring here, I need to make sure I know that and I'm measuring the same point on the other post. So the diagonal from the post that Dan's holding out to here comes out to 107.5. From the center of his post to the center of our post. We know from the manufacturer that the diagonal length on a 30 foot by 96 foot greenhouse is going to be 100 feet and 7 inches. So now by using the 100 foot 7 inch point on this diagonal, the front of this house is going to be 30 feet wide. So the point where that 30 foot intersects the 100 foot 7 is going to be the location of our front right ground post. Right there. So now we'll level this front right post the same way we leveled the left rear post. And we're going to drive that a little bit more. So we have three of our four corner posts in. The next thing is we're going to set that last corner post on the right rear. And we're going to do that by measuring 96 feet back from this post and 30 feet over from that post. And then we'll check it using that diagonal dimension. Dan is going to hold on the center of the post at the ground, and I'm going to measure to what will become the center of the post out here. And then from this back post, we'll come over 30 feet. With any luck where that 30 feet meets that 96 foot. And we'll drive this last corner post the same way we drove the others. So sometimes we'll get these driven in and maybe we don't get the hole lined up properly at first, or maybe it drifts as we drive. And so we can actually rotate these fairly easily with a big long pipe wrench. We hit a pretty serious rock driving in this fourth corner post, and that's good because chances are you're gonna hit a rock too. We have a couple different options when we do. The first thing we'd encourage you to do is when you hit a rock, sometimes it's a small rock that'll rotate a little bit underground, or you'll be able to scooch it off to the side just by continuing to hit. On this one here, it was clear that that wasn't the case. The harder we hit, the more the pipe just started bouncing off that rock in the ground, and it wasn't going anywhere. You do have the option on intermediate posts to occasionally, if the obstruction isn't too high, to actually remove the post and cut the appropriate amount off the bottom of the post. We don't want to do that on a corner post because, of course, that's if we do that, that's going to reduce the ability of that ground post to resist uplift force. And so we can't do that to too many of them. Follow the greenhouse manufacturer's recommendations if you find that you do need to cut the bottom off of one or two posts. This being a corner post, we want to get a full embedment on it. So we've actually chosen to dig out and remove this rock.
That's probably what it was.
Now that we've dug that rock out, we're going to reposition this post just like we did last time. Centered on 30 feet in the width direction and centered on 96 feet in the length. We'll check the diagonal before we drive that too far. You got it good and snug on the middle? 6, we're 1 inch off.
Yep.
So manufacturer's recommendations, we're gonna give tolerances that we can be off on that diagonal. So now that our diagonal is within those tolerances, we'll get this one started. And we'll drive this like the others, and we'll level it like the others, and then we'll come back in and backfill that soil we took off and tamp it down good and firm. Occasionally, we're just not going to be able to get past that deeper rock. We're already driven in enough that we're not interested in lifting this out now. So we're going to actually take the top off the post and re-drill the hole for the bolt that goes through. So we ran a level just like we've done before, and we've leveled it up here. But now the interesting thing is we don't want this string at this bolt hole. This string is going to be at the place where that hole will be. So we get it leveled up and we use that string to mark where that bolt hole is going to go. And then we'll take a drill bit based on the diameter of this that might change from manufacturer, and we'll drill a nice straight hole clean through. So now we're gonna measure 2 inches up from that hole. And again, that's based on this manufacturer. Your manufacturer may have a different hole to the top of the post spacing. Measure 2 inches up from the center. And then using this string, we'll measure that 2-inch mark all the way around. And now with the reciprocating saw, we'll cut off to that mark. Now we'll file that down and be ready to go. So now we have all four of our corner posts laid out, and we've got to set the location for the intermediate posts. So by running a double string along the outside, and we'll actually level this up if we put this where the holes are, now those intermediate posts will go right between these two strings, and we'll know that we need to drive them until their holes intersect the string. So right now I'm going to run this one line looped over between this post and the one at the far back corner. So that's good and secure here. I'm going to go make sure it's equally secure on the other end, and then we're ready to start measuring. So now we'll mark every 4 feet on the ground, and we put that tape in the middle of the pole, and we measured to the middle of the back one. So each one of these marks is going to be at the middle of an intermediate post. We don't want to just measure 4 feet and mark it, and then take another 4 feet and mark it, and take another 4 feet and mark it, because we kind of can multiply our errors that way. So instead we have to do some math, and we have to add 4 all the way out. So I'm going to come down and put a mark at 4 feet. And then 4 plus 4 is 8 and 12, etc. Plus 4 is 92. Plus 4 is 96. So now we're locating the position of the pole along this axis between these two strings. And then where it goes along here is based upon this mark. What's important is that it's lined up with the mark in this direction, but if the mark was a little bit offset, what's really important is that it comes straight down through these two strings. And we level it up, make it nice and plumb, get it in the right direction based on our mark, and then lined up within our strings. And now, because we tied these strings at the bolt holes on the two corner posts, when we drive this in, we know our correct depth is when the bolt hole here lines up with the strings. And we'll drive this, put a drive cap in, and drive this just like the others, and then repeat for the entire line. And then we'll do the same on the other side. We left off driving ground posts, and we've finished driving all those ground posts. Occasionally, you'll hit a rock that'll actually change the level, change the plumb of that post as it's going in. And we want to show you a little technique first on how to straighten those posts back out. So we'll start with a large iron spud bar. These are used to pry rocks out of the ground. And we put a little clamp on there to mark our depth so that it doesn't fall all the way to the bottom of the pipe. Then lower that into the pipe. And we've already checked, it's pretty obvious on this one which way this pipe needs to go, but we've already checked on our level to determine which direction to pull in. And so Chris, with the piece of strapping that we used previously to pull the pipes as they were being driven, he's gonna put some force on that pole. I'm gonna push in this direction. And we'll see if we can get that straightened out. Okay, check that. A little too far in that direction, and a little too far in that direction. Okay. And we got that one straightened out.